Well, right now we know at least 37 people have died in the Kentucky floods. Kentucky Governor Andy Beshear expects that number to climb.
Yeah, authorities are working to rescue those in danger, and volunteers are working to help people get supplies they need. Severe weather is also hitting the West Coast, with fires scorching thousands of acres. NBC's Dan Shenneman has the lead. Kentucky floods have killed more than 30 people and displaced many. A new policy announced yesterday says Knoxville police will respond less often to non-injury crashes. As Knox County educators head back to the classroom, board members are debating how to handle the persistent COVID-19 pandemic.
10 News reporter Grace King joins us in studio to explain. Grace? Number 865-637-1010 right here, and we'll send you a link of all the different ways to get involved. The big event is happening on Saturday.
Yeah, you can actually show up and volunteer. You can donate money to Urban League to help purchase some of those items, but it's filling a big need in our community and helping these kids get starting out on the right foot, I guess you could say, as they start the new school year.
That is right. As Kentucky continues to recover from those deadly floodwaters this week, local organizations are racing to get supplies to hospitals that are in those affected counties.
Yeah, Sydney Darden shares how volunteers are stepping up to provide both medical and non-medical supplies.
Well, finding affordable child care can be difficult for a lot of Tennessee families. The Tennessee Department of Human Services is offering some relief for those parents who are battling the high cost. Here's a look at what's trending today.
Now, social media is buzzing about a pickle. We know you love pickles. That's selling for thousands of dollars.
That's a nice deal.
It also come in handy if you're in the market for a new home. In Knoxville's housing market, not immune to all the nationwide issues like high home prices, high demand, limited supply.
Yeah, it goes on and on. We have tips on securing a home in the midst of a hot economy, especially if you are a first-time home buyer. Right now online, we share more tips from housing experts and why many say the time to buy is now. All on WBIR.com.
Well, check this out. One man has created the world's largest exoskeleton mech suit.
Yeah, so it's a 10-foot tall exoskeleton mech that amplifies your strength by about 50 times.
So the film features two childhood sweethearts, both widowed, who reconnect in solitude in scenic Colorado.
Recently, I talked to Dale about this role, which is a 180 from the violent, harsh characters she usually portrays. Dale talks about the love song, A Love Song, the movie, which includes a country ballad performance and her first ever on-screen kiss. She'll also catch us up on her role as team chaperone in the reboot of A League of Their Own series, which drops Friday on Amazon Prime.
So two big. Some other tips: never use your personal information for your passwords, like your name or your birthday, or maybe your spouse's name, their birthday,
or your children's names. Those are pretty
obvious.
My husband may do that. I don't know. All right, and important tips to keep you and loved ones safe. We always joke about that. Change it up. More than 5,000 kids attended a 4-H camp this summer in the Volunteer State. In one setting, campers experienced what life was like for some of our earliest Tennesseans.
Pioneer Camp includes learning heritage skills and how to survive in the wild. Charles Denny shows us some old-time life lessons. Other skills the 4-H'ers learn at Pioneer Camp include making soap, how to use a slingshot, and cooking food in the outdoors. I think I had fun at Pioneer Camp.
I would love it. Sounds very cool. Well, tomorrow on Live at
She has played before.
All right, we thank you for watching. And if you want to see any information on back to school events, you can visit our website, WBIR.com, for all the details.
10 News at 5 starts right now.